Time is almost upon us in Helsinki. Give us your final thoughts, Duke, as we get close.
I like Froch for this fight just about, because I just think that he's going to match Abrahams in every department, but I would have to question one thing about Abrahams, just his desire, just how much he really wants this. We've seen Froch time and time again being dragged into the deep waters, and we know that he always swims. So, if Froch can drag Abrahams into a real brutal fight, we're going to see what he's all about. I mean, we know what he's all about, but, you know, it's going to become a really, really gruesome fight.
Give me a winner.
Froch on points.
George, give me your final thoughts before we head to ringside.
Both fighters, they're fighting for that WBC belt. They want that title. They're both coming off the back of a loss, so they're both going to be probably as hungry as they've ever been in their careers. I'm going to favour a Froch points decision if he sticks to the game plan. If he doesn't, pick Abraham with a stoppage.
So you're going for Abraham, or you think?
I think if Froch sticks to the game plan, he can win. If he doesn't, and he gets caught in with a trade up, I think Abraham's will come out on top.
You're sitting on the fence a bit. Darren, finishes off. Final thoughts, who's going to win it?
I think it's going to be an absolute belter with Froch winning on points.
In a closely fought contest or in a slugfest, are we looking at?
Like George has said, if he sticks to the game plan, I think he can potentially make this fight, I wouldn't say easy, but he can win comfortably. But if he doesn't stick to it, he does get drawn into, you know, a battle, then he's going to have to win the hard way.
We had a lot of great emails coming in tonight. Thank you to everyone who emailed us in. One or two people concerned about Carl's defence and whether he has to change his style. Do we think he has to change style tonight, or do we want to see Carl be Carl?
Can't change his style. Carl Froch is what he is, you know, and he can't sit on defence because he's got to rely on what he does, and he's got to take the fight to Abrahams, period.
Do you want to see him change, George, or do you want to see him stay the same?
Well, you know, his last 3-4 fights, he's just been in wars, and because he's been at the highest level, trading blows with the top fighters in the world. If he can get back to his boxing that we saw, you know, when he was coming through as a prospect, you know, when he was fighting on a domestic scene, because he can revert back to that, if that's what he's been working on.
Whatever happens tonight, Darren, do we give Carl credit for doing this? Because you guys are prize fighters, you fight for money. Some people would say, take the fights, risk reward, take the biggest money for the least risk. Carl isn't doing that. He's fighting the biggest names in the world.
Oh, he's doing it the hard way, definitely. I mean, there's a lot of easier options he could have taken, but he wants to be the best. He wants to beat the best. And I think this is a great opportunity for him to prove it and to show what a great boxer Carl is. You know, not just he's shown his heart and how good his chin is, but this is a good opportunity to show it how good his boxing skills are.
Carl's girlfriend there, always see her at ringside. She's not difficult, and she's not one you're going to miss her easily. Is that a distraction at all for Carl, having family at ringside? Do you like having family, girlfriend, wives there, or did you like to just no distractions?
No, I prefer having the people I love at the fight. Obviously, my mum will never go, but having my dad there and having all my friends there means a lot to me, and it does really spur me on.
OK, let's get across then. Jimmy Lennon Jr. doing the honours. Our commentary team tonight, Spence Oliver and Ronald McIntosh.
So, Jimmy Lennon Jr. about to intone his familiar call for showtime. Let's hand it over to our Master of Ceremonies for the evening.
King Arthur Abraham!
Here we see Arthur Abrahams bouncing back from his first, hoping to bounce back from his first professional loss. He's succumbed to Andre Dereau by way of disqualification over in the United States. Dereau's home state of Michigan, Joe Louis Arena. Now coming into sight of the crowd for the first time. And an appreciative round of applause greeting the fighter from Armenia who fights out of Germany. This contest, of course, taking place on neutral territory. And now that he's no longer a champion, Spencer, shorn of the regalia that was so much a part of his ring walk and his act. The crown, the opulent robe, far more simple attire tonight.
Yeah, it certainly is, isn't it? It looks a little bit tense on that ring walk. He knows he can't afford to slip up again here this evening. Disqualification last time out against Dereau for hitting him on the floor. Now in against Froch. Froch also coming off that defeat. I think we can expect a real fireworks here this evening. A real 50-50 fight.
So Abrams up into the boxing ring first. There you see the flag of Germany in the corner, and there the Armenian flags. In the crowd here at the Hartwell Arena. Now we await the arrival of the former champion.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is the former world champion, currently ranked the number one world contender from Nottingham, England, introducing Carl the Cobra Froch.
Spotlights train all around the arena, awaiting the arrival of a man looking to regain his crown. And here we see him, dressed in gunfighter black, led out by Robert McCracken, who has been with him at his side for every one of his professional contests. His brother Wayne on the left, promoter Mick Hennessy just behind.
Well, the build-up to this, all this week, Froch has been talking the talk, really up for this contest. Says he's going to go out there, he's going to take the fight to Abrahams. We can expect some real fireworks in there. Abrahams, of course, likes to come forward as well. Carl Froch, really up for this one.
It's going to be interesting to see how both men approach it. You can see him getting rapturous support and applause on the way to the boxing ring. Arthur Abrahams' team were trying to play into the hands of the home crowd. Trying to say that Carl Froch was disrespectful about the fine city of Helsinki. But just look at the reception he's received en route to the ring. His cheers perhaps louder than those of Arthur Abrahams.
Yeah, he's taken a good crowd over with him here this evening. A tremendous reception there for Carl Froch. Looks nice and relaxed, getting the final words there from his trainer, Robert McCracken. Now, the tactics, I think, for Froch will be to try and keep it long, but as we all know, Carl Froch so easily gets drawn into a fight. The last three contests he's had, every one of them have been real brutal wars, and I think we can expect that again this evening. I don't think it'll be long before Froch gets involved in that fight.
Final instructions being passed on from Robert McCracken. Will Froch heed those instructions? Will he execute the game plan, which he says is to keep it long, and it could be a relatively easy night's work? Will he be able to curb that warrior instinct, that thirst he has for a tear-up? But it's all of these imponderables that give us the fantastic fight we have in prospect.
At this time, in honour of both of the boxers, we ask you to please stand for the playing of the national anthems. And we begin with the national anthem of Great Britain.
See the logo of Robin Hood on the right breast
of
Carl Froch. Forest fans in attendance as well. We have the German anthem.
raised applause at the conclusion of the German national anthem. Both fighters now derobed.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening
in preparation
and
for the opening bell.
Hyvät naiset ja herrat, tervetuloa. We welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, to Hart Wall Arena here in Helsinki, Finland, for the featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Sauerland Event in association with Hennessy Sports and Showtime. This bout is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council, the President Jose Suleiman, and the Supervisor Bob Logist. Introducing to you our three judges scoring this bout from ringside. From Reno, Nevada, in the United States, Bert Clements. From Villa Park, California, in the United States, Max DeLuca. And from Dallas, Texas, in the United States, Oren Schellenberger. And our third man to the ring, the referee in charge, he'll be giving instructions after the introductions from Lincoln Park, Michigan, Frank Garza. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. It's the Super 6 World Boxing Classic, and it's scheduled 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from Helsinki, Finland, introducing to you first, on my left, fighting out of the red corner, wearing black trunks, he is known as boxing's pride of Nottingham, England. He weighed in at 75.8 kilos, or 166 and 3 quarter pounds, with a record of 26 wins and 1 loss. He has 20 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the confirmed Super 6 semifinalist, currently ranked the WBC number one contender. Here is the former WBC Super Middleweight Champion of the World, introducing Carl the Cobra Frost.
Huge applause for the Nottingham fighter.
And his opponent across the ring on my right, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing white trunks with black lettering and fighting out of Berlin, Germany. He weighed in at an even 76 kilos, or 167 and 1 quarter pounds. His record stands at 31 wins, 1 loss, with 25 big wins coming by way of knockout. He also is a confirmed Super 6 semifinalist, ranked the WBC number 2 contender. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the former middleweight champion of the world, introducing King. Once again, a referee in charge now to give instructions, Frank Garza.
Okay, gentlemen, we went over all the rules. Both of you, I couldn't ask for a better place to have your belt lines. Keep them up above the trunks. Touch hands, come out at the bell, may the best man win.
Well, a reluctant touch of gloves between these two proud warriors. Ahead of what could well be a fight of the year candidate.
Ready? Ready?
So here we go then, the first of a scheduled 12 rounds for the vacant WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World. The latest installment of the Super 6 World Boxing Classic between a former champion, Carl the Cobra Frotch from Nottingham, left of your screen wearing black trunks trimmed with white. He's facing the former IBF middleweight champion of the world, fighting out of Germany from Armenia, King Arthur Abrahams.
Well, as expected, Arthur Abrahams taking center of the ring, that high-held guard. And Frotch just pushing out that jab. Carries that left hand so low.
Abrahams, a notoriously slow starter, said this week during the build-up to the contest that that is something he's going to try to remedy. So will we see a faster start from Abrahams we've been accustomed to? Lunging right hand easily evaded by Frotch.
Yeah, just out distance there. Too eager to get that shot off, and Cole Crotch doing a good job of turning things around there and letting a few nice punches go himself.
Crotch, the taller man, 6'1". 5'10", Arthur Abrahams. And these two first met at the announcement, the initial announcement of this tournament. And the draw revealed that these two would meet at some stage as Frosch gets through with a corkscrew left jab around the corner, almost a half hook, and the right hand down the pipe as well. He said that he would relish fighting this man. He didn't realise he was as small as he actually is.
Well, Frosch at the moment, boxing to instructions, doing what he said he was going to do, keeping it at distance, working well with the jab, and Abrahams at the moment struggling to find his range in this first round.
Watch that familiar low-held guard. These two couldn't be more contrasting in that respect, and they receive the right uppercut, which could be a key weapon in this contest. Fell short from Frotch on that occasion. They'll get through with the second left jab. Again, you see the head of Arthur Abrahams snapping back. Is Frotch able to pierce the high-held guard with an accurate left?
Yeah, good start from Frotch. He's ramming that jab in the face of Abrahams. Abrahams a little bit static in there at the moment. We'd like to see him just move his head from side to side.
Frotch got through with a good right hand to the body. Looking for, he's staying, looking for more movement for Abraham, just as Frotch displays variety and scores with a long left to the body. But variety isn't really the hallmark of Arthur Abraham's game. That's the thing, that's what makes him so effective. You know what he's going to do. And in all but one contest, he's been successful doing it inside the final 10 seconds of the opening round. So the bell sounds to conclude the first round of boxing. Spencer Oliver, your immediate thought?
Yeah, great start there from Cole Frotch. Done what he said he was going to do, stuck to the game plan, kept it at long range, worked well with the jab, piercing through the guard of Abrahams. There, Abrahams lunging in with the right hand, and Frotch quickly turning it back around and letting a nice cluster of punches go. But a very good start there from Cole Frotch.
See the lead right uppercut that he attempted, fell short, but the momentum of that offensive foray was enough to force Abraham backwards.
If you don't stay there, come on, relax, relax.
Into the second round we go. Just perhaps heard Robert McCracken instructing Frotch, telling him to not stay there. Punch and move, don't stay in range for the heavy artillery to be on the receiving end of the heavy artillery that Abraham possesses.
Well, that's your worry, isn't it? If Frotch can keep it at range like this, you know, I think he could keep it quite comfortable, but at some point I'm sure Abraham is going to draw Frotch in. But Frotch at the start of this contest getting success with that left jab.
Again, that has been a hallmark of Arthur Abraham's victories. Carries that power tremendously late. But the question is, Spencer, will he bring that power up to 168, career-long middleweight, until the inception of this tournament? And even the knockout victory that he scored over Jermaine Taylor, he was practically a career-long middleweight as well. So fighting a man roughly the same size, Cole Frotch, a natural super middle, naturally the bigger man.
Well, Frotch certainly thinks that that's going to play a big factor here this evening. But that will remain to be seen, Ron. If Frotch doing a nice things here in this opening part of the contest, working well, keeping it at good range. And Abraham just looking a little bemused in there at the moment.
Good variety from Frotch, snaking out a long left to the body. Right hand almost got around the left hand of Arthur Abraham as well. That guard of old, there's that right uppercut again. That didn't get through, but the right hook around the corner did. Good work from Frotch here in the second round. And that jab just piling up points, and a long right to the torso as well as Abraham.
Yeah, looking really comfortable in there at the moment, Frotch, isn't he? And Abraham again just letting that right hand go, but just out of distance. Needs to close that gap, needs to step in more, Abraham. Needs to get that head moving, because at the moment, Froch dominating at long range.
Froch enjoying a three-inch advantage in height and a two-inch advantage in reach. And he's employing that to wonderful effect throughout his first two rounds of boxing. But again, have to stress that Abrams is a thunderous puncher of the highest order, but in Froch's opinion, and indeed the record bears it out, all down at 160 pounds, middleweight, good right hand from Froch. And then Froch belting the body, brings a reaction from Abrams, if they didn't hurt me, but when that happens, Spence, you know you've got the fighter's attention. Froch teeing off here in the second round, wonderful punching from the Nottingham fighter. Fantastic variety.
Well, you know what's noticeable here, Ron, is when Froch is landing the shots, although they're landing on the gloves, it seems to be moving Abraham. It seems to be pushing him back. So you know them punches are having an effect, and a good right hand over the top right on the bell there from Cole Froch.
Two rounds completed, and the face of Arthur Abraham already beginning to mark up and redden from the stinging, venomous punches of the Cobra. Let's see what Robert McCracken's saying over there in this corner. Can't hear the instruction to the Nottingham fighter at the moment, but if Abraham said he was going to start quickly, he hadn't done so.
No, he certainly hasn't, has he? Here we see some of the good work from Froch. There's that corkscrew right uppercut. And Froch again keeping it at range, not getting caught with anything there. And most of the good work in that round done from Cole Froch, switching well from body to head, and another good round. This is exactly how he needs to keep it now, Cole Froch. Keep it at long range, keep it like that. Throw them right uppercuts. He was getting success with that in that second round.
The mouthpiece with the colours of the German flag inserted back into the mouth of Arthur Abrams as we begin round number three, scheduled for 12. The vacant WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World at stake. Froch pumping out that jab to begin the third round. And again, Abrams yet to find the range. You see Froch mixing it up nicely to head and body. That a smart tactic, because traditionally Abraham just cuffs those gloves around his head, Spencer, and marches forward.
Well, that's what Abraham's struggling with, Ron. He's struggling with the variety of punches from Cole Froch. Froch is doing a great job switching body, switching head, leading with right uppercuts, and that's exactly what he needs to do, because Arthur Abraham looking confused in there at the moment. He can't get past that left jab of Cole Froch.
Body again from Froch. The double jab as Abrams continuing to fall short with his own jab. Cole Froch boxing beautifully at the moment here as we approach the halfway mark of round number three. Right hand lead from Froch.
Yeah, seems to be settling in nicely there, doesn't he? Cole Froch leading with left hooks, right hands, everything going according to plan at the moment.
Here a chant going up of Arthur, Arthur. As Froch again connects with another snapping left hand.
Well, Arthur's throwing his shots from out of range, left foot. He's not close enough to Cole Froch, and he seems to be falling in with his shots. A good little cluster there, though, from Arthur, got closer. But yeah, just out of range at the moment. Abraham.
A little successful combination he put together did get the attention of Froch. Abraham is a heavy-handed hitter. These fighters have confirmed their place in the semi-final stage of the Super Six. Abraham gets through with a good right hand, straight right. But Froch continuing to command center ring. His right hand was wild and long and over the top on that occasion.
Well, you can see a change in the pattern here. Now Cole Froch is going on the front foot, and you feel that the pattern of this fight could change, and it could be starting to become more of a brawl as it goes on, as expected.
Indeed, Froch was boxing. Oh, beautiful straight shots, right, left, right. Abraham pinned to the ropes near the red corner. Again, he waves in Froch, displaying machismo. But it's Froch and a good right uppercut gets through. It's Froch who's getting the better of these exchanges. As the bell sounds to conclude round number three.
Yeah, tremendous cluster of punches there from Cole Froch, and another good round. And Abraham at the moment struggling to get in this one. He can't get past that left jab of Cole Froch, and Froch just seems to be easing into this contest.
Go that way. Do you understand me? Away from the right hand like you've trained. Sharp jab and right hand. I don't want you going big. When you're up close, just really short, and then back on the long jabs and right hands. But you've got to be busy, mate. Okay, busier than that. But when he moves away from you, you're in control.
Well, there you heard the instruction of Robert McCracken to Carl Froch. Stay away from that right hand.
Yeah, he wants him to box at long range, doesn't he? I think that's where he feels comfortable for Carl Froch. He wants to keep it at distance. Unfortunately for him, though, Cole Froch, as you know, Ron, and as we've seen through his career, loves to get involved in a tear-up, and that's the way it seemed to be going in that third round. Froch just starting to stand his ground.
Did get the better of those exchanges, though, as we begin round number four. In this rescheduled contest. Remember, it was supposed to have taken place at the start of October in Monaco. Froch again has success with a long straight shot to the body, but a back injury suffered by Carl Froch in training caused the contest to be postponed and the venue moved north from the Millionaires Playground of Monaco to the frozen Nordic country of Finland. In Helsinki, Hartwell Arena, just the second world title bout for men to be contested in this country. And the first one since 1962.
Well, this is good again from Cole Froch, keeping it at range. That's where he needs to be, letting that jab go, taking half a step back, because that's where Abraham is confused. You see there, missing wildly, and Froch using that footwork to get himself out of trouble. This is good boxing here from Cole Froch.
As you've already referred to, Spencer, when you look back at his recent list of opponents, and the attritional war that they have been, it's often hard to forget, or it's easy to forget rather, that Froch demonstrated this type of movement as an amateur early in his professional career. But good footwork being used by the Nottingham man. He just continues to keep Arthur Abrahams occupied with those straight shots. And again, that one got around the guard of Abrahams, and good variety once more from Froch. Body shots and then upstairs to the head, the lead right uppercut.
Yeah, really mixing it up well, isn't he? Abraham's confused, doesn't know where the next shot's coming from. Excellent boxing here from Cole Froch.
Fighting exchange jabs there, but Cole Froch just keeping him at long range and then mixing it up so well. Again, you get a glimpse of the reddened face of Arthur Abraham. Oh, good, strong, stiff, snapping jab from Froch. Just rocks the thick neck back of Arthur Abrahams. And he's really being put on the end of some good boxing from the Nottingham fighter.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration there from Abraham, just rushing in, but Cole working so well with that left jab, really ramming it home, isn't he? Abraham's now just trying to pick the pace up, trying to throw the clusters of punches, but nothing really getting through.
Abraham being reduced to single swings, it seems like, as he had a bit of success with the jab on that occasion. And again, you see, Abraham's thought about the right hand, didn't pull the trigger, and it was a rather clumsy amateurish foray forwards as Froch goes jab body, jab head, and then a right hand as well. Wonderful boxing from the Cobra.
Yeah, another good round there from Cole Froch, mixing his shots up. There's that ramrod jab that we see, really driving that shot in. And an excellent array of shots to body and head from Cole Froch. And Abraham's looking frustrated there in the fourth round.
Here we see Carl's girlfriend, Rachel, accordingly. Two of them had their first child earlier this summer. Baby Rocco, a new addition to the family.
You've got to concentrate the whole time. Behind the jab and the right hand, have another swallow. Listen to me.
1-2 move, 1-2 shot.
Well, good instructions there.
You see the fervent support from his family ringside here at the Hartwell Arena. But clear instructions from Robert McCracken, concentrate the whole time.
Well, them instructions are working, aren't they, Ron? I mean, he's won them first four rounds for me, and he's won them quite clearly, keeping it at long range, doing it behind the jab, the old clusters of punches, and Abraham looking frustrated.
So the adaptation that Arthur Abraham's promised to make after suffering his first professional loss in his previous contest, that disqualification at the hands of Andre Durell when he struck him when he was clearly on the canvas in the 11th round of their Super 6 contest. Said he was going to start this one faster, not give away the early rounds. Hasn't done so, and we have to credit Carl Froch for that. See him make a motion with his right leg. Hopefully that was just showboating. He hasn't got a problem with any of the joints on that appendage.
No, he seems to be in his comfort zone in there. Looks like he's in total control, seems to be enjoying himself. This is a different Cole Froch we're seeing here this evening, keeping it at long range. We know how much he loves to get in a fight, and Abraham exactly the same, but Froch applying the right tactics here.
Applying the right tactics and fighting his fight to a T. Good right hand to the body. It's that type of variety he's displayed throughout this contest, and it's keeping Arthur Abrahams guessing. Perhaps this isn't what he expected from Carl Froch.
No, you know what, I think Abraham expected that. He expected Froch to be standing in front of him, trading up, but Froch is just doing his work. He's first for the punch, and then he's moving, creating the space, and he's not there to be hit. Abraham's looking frustrated at the moment.
Froch working particularly well to the body in this stanza. And Abraham's not noted for his movement. By investing in these body shots early, that could well reap dividends and slow the movement that Abraham has as we get longer, deeper into the fight.
Yes. Good work of game there. Abraham looking for that right hand over the top. Froch doing a good job of moving there. Really whipping in those shots, wasn't he?
Veritably stopped Abraham in his tracks, and Abraham is being reduced to crude swings from the outside. Froch able to see them coming and evade them with aplomb. Jab to body, jab to head again from Froch. And he is making this appear comfortable. And you hear Robert McCracken crying from ringside, and again, that jab just backing up Abraham with force, and perhaps he's just trying to clear his head and think, well, how do I negate this? How do I get around this?
And a good left hook landed again from Froch there. Yeah, Abraham's there. We see him jumping in, looking very frustrated, and a good right hand there from Froch.
And momentarily, Arthur Abraham's just stopped. No physical damage, but again, perhaps just give himself some thinking time as we approach the bell here in round number 5. Good left hand from Froch, right on the bell. He's in complete control of this Super 6 contest after 5 rounds of boxing.
Yeah, another dominant round there from Carl Froch. There we see the jab going through the guard. That's the shot Abraham's struggling to deal with. Abraham can't get past that. Froch is doing a great job of keeping it at range. Now throwing clusters of punches like that one there. Really effective. There we see the screw right uppercut. And a tremendous display of boxing from Carl Froch. And there again, Abraham out of distance. And another round dominated from Carl Froch.
See the markings on Abraham's face. His coach, Uli Wegner, got it all to do to get his charge back into this fight. Let's take a listen to Robert McCracken.
Well, interesting there. Robert McCracken telling Froch he's got to be busier, but for me, he's certainly doing enough. I think he's just trying to keep him busy, get him to keep at range, throw those clusters of punches. Everything he's doing, the advice he's taking is perfect.
Froch continuing to occupy ring center, a wide-legged stance. pumping out hurtful lefts and rights. And even though they're being, some of them being caught on the forearms and gloves of Abrahams, it's negating any offense that he's trying to put together. You see him falling short with his jab continually, as Froch just contracting and expanding the ring as he likes with good use of the legs.
Well, you know what's happening here, Rob. Well, it is Cole Froch is throwing the combinations of punches. As soon as he's finished throwing that combination, he's gone. Abrahams is taking too much time to get off of his shots. He's holding the high guard. Abraham, if he wants to get himself back into this contest, he needs to start leading off first. He needs to start trying to create the openings. It's no good just walking forward with your hands held high. Cole Froch is too clever for that. He's proved that through his whole career, amateur and pro. And at the moment, he's in complete control in there.
Finally decorated amateur, of course, Cole Froch. National ABA champion, as the left hand continues to do damage and mark up the face of Arthur Abraham. Of course, cut that amateur career with that bronze medal at the World Amateur Championships in Belfast 2001. Had the privilege of seeing him and David Hay step onto the medal rostrum there. Oh, beautiful right hook around the guard of Arthur Abrahams. And this is almost target practice for the Cobra. Good variety, down to the body. Abrahams backing up.
Yeah, just seemed to get hurt there momentarily from that body shot. Just seemed to double up, didn't he? Cole Froch doing a tremendous job, really mixing the shots up so well. Body, head, all sorts of variety, and a tremendous punch-perfect performance so far from Cole Froch.
Abraham did get through with a good left jab in that previous exchange. You see it score again. But surely that is not enough to be turning the tide in his favour. Because at the conclusion of six rounds, unless he unleashes one of his thunderbolts, he could well find himself six rounds down on our card. Oh, wild right hand from Cole Froch. He doesn't want to be doing that. And that gives Abraham a bit of success, or at least encouragement, as he comes forward with a forehand. Steve Froch looked to his corner. No doubt Robert McCracken would have been telling him, stay on the game plan.
Yes.
Oh, and Abraham is down. Ruled a slip. No knockdown.
Yeah, it just seemed to be a little slip there, but Carl Froch seems to be really oozing confidence in there at the moment, doesn't he?
And the conclusion of round number six. Spencer Oliver, how do you see it?
Well, another round there for Cole Froch. I mean, I think he's boxing perfectly to all tactics here, keeping it at long range, throwing the shots, and round after round, the same thing is happening. Arthur Abraham is coming forward with a high-held guard, and he's just walking forward, and Froch is throwing the clusters of punches and stealing the rounds. Here we see the little flurry at the end of the round. That's where Froch wanted to take it to Abraham, but there it was. It was around the back of the neck, just a little slip, not ruled a knockdown.
You see him touch down, but it was more a case of getting tangled up rather than from a clean shot.
There you see it, my scorecard after six rounds. I've got it all to Cole Froch, boxing beautifully, punch perfect at the moment.
Six rounds completed, potentially six rounds to go in this battle for the vacant WBC Super Middleweight Championship of the World. The latest installment of the Super Six World Boxing Classic, and Cole Froch is boxing superbly. You see that jab just tripping out. Always, oh, good left-right combination. The right hand again rubbed the head back of Abraham and sent him backwards.
You know, that's what Abraham is struggling to deal with, Ron. He's struggling to get past that jab. There's not enough lateral movement.
And again, lateral movement, not a hallmark, as Froch putting short, arcing punches together on the inside. And Abraham just continuing to mark up around the eyes. And his body language doesn't appear to be fantastic.
No, he's not coming back with much, is he? And at the moment, Cole Froch completely dominating.
He said he was looking forward to this, and Froch seems to be reveling in the performance that he's producing here for this Hartwell Arena crowd on neutral territory in Finland. He is boxing superbly, and Arthur Abraham, a man normally so patient, His face seldom betrays anything. He's beginning just to look a little bit desperate. His mouth is open. He appears to be sucking wind. And Carl Froch putting his punches together superbly, driving Abraham back to a neutral corner. Froch unloading with left and right. Abraham trying to evade the shots.
Yeah, he needs to come back with something here, Abraham. Froch completely dominating, mixing the shots up so well, body and head, and there's nothing coming back from Abraham at all.
The right uppercut tried by Froch, and so far, Art Abraham is boxing exactly as Carl Froch predicted he would, because it's been nothing other than a high-held guard and plodding forward, but there's been no success this time with the forward forays of the German fighter.
Well, Froch has done his homework, hasn't he, and he's stuck to tactics, and they're working so well. I mean, Abraham's the one that needs to change the game plan here, but trouble is, Ron, I don't think he's got a plan B. I think what you see is what you get from Abraham.
Sorry, Spencer, but that was a sickening jab. Fired out from down by the knee of Carl Froch, a la Tommy Hitman Hearns, and just snapped the head back of Abraham.
Getting a good right uppercut, right hook round the back of the guard.
And you see Carl Froch just flashing that malevolent grin as he's prone to do. And he's enjoying his work. And he's enjoying his work with good reason in this contest, because he is boxing fantastically well through seven rounds here in this WBC super middleweight title bid. Abraham continuing to fall short, stopped again in his tracks by a stiff left, hard right hand to the body, right on the bell. And Carl Froch leaving a strong impression in the mind of the judges at the conclusion of almost every round.
Well, another dominant round again there from Carl Froch. Here we see some of the action in the round, really putting the shots together well in threes and fours. An excellent variety of shots as well, isn't it? I mean, tremendous. I mean, you struggled to give Arthur Abraham one round so far. I mean, Carl Froch really punched perfect through the first seven rounds.
And how much has this taken Arthur Abraham by surprise? Because given Froch's record in recent fights, as you see a cut down by the right side of his mouth.
Well, you know,
mark up around the eyes as well.
And also, he's the one that seems to be blowing, isn't he? Froch is the one that's doing all the work, but Abraham is obviously having an effect because he's the one that looks the tighter of the two. And Carl Froch looks in complete control. He looks in second gear out there at the moment.
Into the eighth round we go, scheduled for 12. WBC, vacant WBC super middleweight title on the line. Carl Froch trying to regain the title that he lost in his last contest to Mikel Kessler. You can perhaps just see him in the expensive seats ringside towards the center left of our screen. And you see Wilfried Sauerland just straightening up, but he had his head in his hands, the German promoter, because Carl Froch is continuing to box superbly, displaying his full repertoire of punches to both head and body, straight, short arcing punches. And Arthur Abraham has done next to nothing in terms of successful offense.
Well, you know, you'd expect Abraham to try and take the fight a little bit now to Froch, because he's starting to get near desperate times now. We're in the second half of the contest. Abraham hasn't won a round so far. You'd like to see him try and change it. He needs to change it, because whatever Carl Froch is doing out there at the moment is working.
Flip side of that, Spencer, is that his game plan is patently not working. The strategy carefully put together at the Kinebaum Training Center in Brandenburg. Coming up short. Good right hand to the body from Froch.
You don't get no sense of urgency from Abraham, do you? He just seems to be covering up and in survival mode at the moment. I mean, Carl Froch just teeing him off here. Real big shots going in, Ron.
He's displaying machismo, but he's coming out a distant second best as Carl Froch is landing hurtful lefts and rights. You see Carl Froch just responding in kind, and he can afford to do that because after seven completed rounds, he's way ahead on the scorecard. Abraham, there's got to be some greater alacrity about his work from here on in, because we've passed the halfway stage, and he's a distant second best, just warned by the referee about use of the elbow. The rough, tough customer, Arthur Abraham. Froch isn't allowing him to executed game plan in any way, shape or form.
Well, that's the key to success in this contest. Frotch is not getting drawn into a fight. He's keeping it at range. It's working for him. If it ain't broke, don't try and fix it. What Frotch is doing at the moment is completely dominating.
Abraham hasn't displayed the tendency to adapt, and he just eats another jab from Frotch. And being completely outclassed, it has to be said, a world-class elite fighter himself. IBF middleweight king with 10 successful defenses, hard right uppercut to the solar plexus from Frotch, and you just saw Abraham exhale.
Yeah, took a deep gulp of breath there, didn't he? And Frotch just seems to be picking it up here. I think he can sense. Abraham seems to be feeling the pace more than himself.
Another strong finish to cap another dominant round. And that is as dispirited as I have seen Arthur Abraham at any point in his career, having watched most of his fights.
Well, he walked back to the corner, didn't he, with his head slumped. You know, that's not the sign of a confident man. Cole Frotch here demonstrating excellent power, excellent variety, and Abraham just left on the ropes covering up. He really looks disheartened in there at the moment, Abraham. And Cole Frotch having the time of his life.
And you see him displaying machismo, saying, well, that didn't hurt, but time not on his side. He's got to use that time to get busy and try and force his way back into the fight. Let's listen to Rob McCracken.
So we bust him up with that jab. The jab will kill him if you keep doing
it.
The jab will kill him if you, But listen, the jab will do it if you keep working. But you can't put single shots on the stage.
Paul Frotch's family ringside, his brother Wayne up shouting instruction, his girlfriend Rachel accordingly.
Oh yeah, perfect instructions again there from McCracken, just telling him the jab's working, so just keep it going. I mean, Abraham now getting into desperation times, we're going into the last quarter of the fight, and Abraham really needs to start trying to change the pattern here, because Cole Frotch is dominating.
Has he lost a round on your card at this point, Spencer?
No, Frotch? He certainly hasn't. For me, Frotch has won every round and won them clearly, Ron. I can't even give a share of a round to Abraham.
So Abraham breathing out of an open mouth, and again, as he tries to fire his own shot, he's just stopped dead in his tracks by a ramrod left from Frotch. Continuing to piston out that jab, and it's keeping Abraham at bay. You heard the instruction in the corner from Robert McCracken, and he's executing it almost to perfection.
Yeah, he has been punched perfect here this evening, but you get no sense of urgency from Abraham, do you? Look, he's just there, he's just throwing out the odd jab and covering up. There's no sense of urgency. You'd think he was fighting like he was eight rounds in front.
He most certainly isn't, at least according to our scorecard and from our perspective. But he hasn't demonstrated the ability to fight differently strategically. As Frotch puts another... Oh! Left-right combination from Frotch. Buckles the knees of Arthur Abraham. He could well be ready for the taking here from Frotch. Does Frotch sense that? Will he throw caution to the wind, or will he continue to box patiently? Minute and a half to go in round number nine.
Well, I think it was that straight left hand through the middle one that seemed to do the damage.
Arthur Abraham beginning to wilt as these shots whip home now from Cole Frotch. He's continuing to come forward, but there's no real intent. And again, another jab just stops his forward momentum.
That really has been the key shot in this contest, hasn't it? That ramrod jab through the middle. Abraham hasn't been able to get past that. Not enough lateral movement. And Frotch dominated here again in the ninth round.
Are his legs back beneath him, Arthur Abraham, as he walked into range and just took another clubbing right hook around the ear from Cole Frotch. Abraham just falling short, those shots just catching the forearms of Frotch. Oh, beautiful angles and variety once more from Cole Frotch. Long left hook from the outside. And Arthur Abraham is looking a dispirited fighter.
Yeah, he certainly is, isn't he? There's not a lot of fight left in Arthur Abraham. Taking a deep gulp of air there as we go back. And Cole Frotch really looking confident, oozing confidence.
Oh, and another right hand. Excuse me, Spencer. Just dips the knees of Arthur Abraham. Desperately swinging now, but again, you see him falling short with his shot. It's almost like an older sibling keeping his younger sibling at bay with that straight left hand, and Arthur Abraham is in trouble. Falling short with his punches and getting clipped by clean shots from Cole Frotch at the conclusion of round nine.
And another dominant round there Cole Frotch throwing tremendous clusters of punches, and that's the difference. Cole Frotch is finding the target. Arthur Abraham isn't. He's falling short. He's not stepping in with the shots. The confidence seems to be going. And there you see my scorecard after 9 rounds. Completely dominant from Cole Frotch. And that's the reason why the clusters of punches that we're seeing now.
And Cole Frotch just seems to have an answer, have a response for everything that Arthur Abraham tries. And there you see him, Abraham, follow through with the elbow, but what can I do? That seems to be what is running through the mind of Abraham.
Well, I think that's the problem, Ron. I don't think he can change his game plan. Cole Frotch is stuck to his. He was hoping that at some point Frotch would get drawn into a fight, but it hasn't happened, and this man looks totally defeated at the moment, Arthur Abraham.
To round 10 we go, scheduled for 12. Super 6 World Boxing Classic, this innovative tournament, the brainchild of the TV paymaster Showtime in America, to bring the top 6 168-pound fighters together. Oh, Abraham in real trouble, wilting now. Right uppercut, left hook. Abraham ready for the taking. Cole Frotch pouring it on here in round number 10.
Yeah, Frotch senses Abraham's ready to go here, and he looks on unsteady legs. And you feel that Cole Frotch is going to start picking it up here in his 10th round.
Cole Frotch as fresh as a proverbial daisy. Despite 10 rounds of boxing in his legs, Arthur Abraham, on the other hand, is wilting and sagging, mainly thanks to punches like that. Cole Frotch managing to breach the guard, the usually trusty guard of Arthur Abraham. But he's been leaky and porous tonight. And we have to give credit to the accurate punching of Cole Frotch, where he's created angles with a variety of jabs, straight left jab, corkscrew left jab, round the corner left hook, as we saw there. All the punches being demonstrated by Frotch, and Abraham has no answer.
Yeah, that's exactly it. That's exactly it, Ron. He's mixing up tremendous variety of punches, body and head, incomplete control, and Arthur Abraham doesn't know what shot's coming next.
Coming back from his first professional defeat, Abraham, the two fighters coming back from their first professional losses. Good left jab again, just seems to sicken Abraham. Two fighters trade left hand that time. Frotch can't get careless. But Frotch said that in that fight with Kessler, they were clearly were delayed from the volcanic ash. Oh, left hand doubles over Abraham. Abraham really being put to the sword here by the Nottingham fighter.
Yeah, tremendous left hook straight under the elbow there of Arthur Abraham, and he looks desperate, doesn't he? Cole Frotch in complete control here, and Abraham really in survival mode.
Cole Frotch can't afford to get complacent, because this man does possess thunderous punching power, as again he goes downstairs with a right hand to the body, follows up with a right hand to the head. Two left hooks club home from Frotch. He forces retaliation from Abraham. As cool as you could possibly be, evades them all too easily. This is a masterful boxing performance from Cole Frotch.
Yeah, he hasn't been drawn into any fight at all, has he? And he's dominated this from the opening bell. Everything coming from behind the jab. And Abraham looking totally frustrated and totally outclassed at the moment.
The bell sounds to conclude round number 10. And it's a long, weary-legged walk back to the blue corner for Arthur Abraham, because he has just been on the end of a fantastic boxing lesson. Here we see the former WBA and WBC champion, Mikel Kessler. He must appreciate what he's seen tonight from his great rival.
Yeah, tremendous boxing display from Frotch right from the opening bell. And Abraham really looking frustrated, hasn't got off of any sort of shots of his own. Cole Frotch dominated really from the first bell, as we're seeing here. This is what has happened through the first 10 rounds.
Switch off. You've got two rounds left, 6 minutes. Yeah, it works. If you switch off, I'm telling you now, he'll catch you and he'll hurt you. Carl, jab, jab, right hand. Chin on your chest, gloves up. Move the feet away. Do you put out a slow shot or stay there? Jab, jab, right hand.
You heard the instruction from Robert McCracken. And from his point of view and from British fight fans' point of view, Karl Froch is heeding and executing those instructions.
Well, he has, he's been punched perfect, and the instructions there from Robert McCracken is don't switch off, two rounds to go. You're in complete control, you can't allow him to get back into the contest. Just keep him at range, keep him behind the jab. But looks in complete control, and Abraham again just sagging at the knees.
More fantastic combination punching from Karl Froch. Barely a mark on his face. And Arthur Abraham's in stark contrast is reddened and busted up and swollen up around the eyes and forehead.
Well, nothing's worked for Abraham this evening, has it? But the trouble is, Ron, he hasn't changed his game plan from the opening bell. He knew that wasn't working from the opening bell, but he hasn't got a B plan, and a wicked right left hook round the side of the guard there. And Abraham's again looking unsteady.
Increasingly wilting as the fight progresses off Abraham. And Karl Froch whipping and a variety of straight punches as well. But look, Ron, he looks so fresh, and look at the concern, if you can just see ringside, on the face of Wilfred Sauerland and Callie Sauerland. They know that their man is way down. There's only a round and a half of boxing to go.
Well, you know, there's no sense of urgency, though. He hasn't changed the pace. We're in the 11th round. We're halfway through the 11th round, and a body shot.
Drama here. You saw Abraham complain that it was a low blow, but the referee having none of it. He said, get on with it. As Froch goes back and invests in body shots once more. Two left hands to the body. Abraham wilting. Froch now switches his attack to the head. Abraham, whose movement has become statuesque. Well, to the accurate, precise punching of Karl Froch, a referee taking a close look.
Them body shots really did play a part there. Abraham really felt the weight of those. You see him wincing when those left hooks landed. That's the reason there's no movement. And Froch completely dominated here and could be on the verge of an excellent victory.
Abraham being backed up. The referee's taking a close look. Wild left hook swing from Karl Froch. Doesn't need to demonstrate that, because when he's sticking to textbook punches, he has had a huge amount of success. Right hand to the body once more. And all of these just stiffening the legs and reducing the movement. Clubbing right-left combination. Karl Froch up on his toes, dancing away to his left.
Yeah, Abraham's looking like a defeated man in there, isn't he? Frayed shots too far out, getting caught on the counter. Another excellent round here from Karl Froch.
Two fighters exchange stiff jabs that time, but the bell sounds, and that hasn't come a moment too soon for Arthur Abraham, because he was being doubled over by some hurtful shots to the body from Karl the Cobra Froch. And here we see the former WBA heavyweight champion of the world, Nikolai Valuev.
Last round.
Well, I'm sure he'll be appreciating this masterclass of boxing from Karl Froch. Really demonstrating excellent body punching there, Froch. Here we see him mixing the shots up. Abrahams was thinking about going down, a little dip in the knees, and then Froch switching the shots underneath the elbows so well. And another dominant round, there we see it. And Abraham doubling up, wincing in pain. And another dominant round from Karl Froch. And Ron, I can't give Abraham a round. I've got Karl Froch 11 rounds up going into this 12th round.
See the grim expression on the face of Nikolai Valuev, because a fighter from his style and promotional group is being outclassed. Cursory touch of blood between the two fighters as we enter the 12th and final round. A good hard right hand from Abraham, though, to begin the contest. Left hand follows up. Has that hurt Karl Froch? He's trying to demonstrate a poker face, but the best punch of the contest lands for Abraham. Karl Froch can't afford to be careless. He was struck by a rabbit punch, but prior to that, two thunderous clean shots straight onto the point of his chin.
Yeah, Froch can't afford to get careless here. He can't afford to go full to sleep. Them right hands are really thudding shots over the top of that left hand, which Froch has started to carry so low. He must stick to the game plan, keep it at long range.
Can't afford to switch off, and Karl Froch knows that you have to box until the final bell, because again, remember, he walked down and pursued and turned around the deficit against Jermaine Taylor in the first defence of his super middleweight title before catching up with him and stopping him in the 12th and final round. Surely that's not going to be the fate that befalls him here.
No, he's got back to his boxing. He's done the wrong thing, trying to stand his ground with Abraham. He knows he's got this clearly won. He just needs to keep it at long range, keep pushing out the jab, get that left hand back tight. Another ramrod jab going in there from Carl Froch. And again, demonstrating the tremendous boxing skills, body and head. Another tremendous right hand going through there.
Fantastic variety once again from Froch. He appears to have weathered that mini crisis and has come back with belting hooks to the body of his own. But that was an interesting index of awareness to begin that round, because despite the pummeling that Arthur Abraham has taken, he came out and landed some thunderous shots which clearly caught the attention of the Cobra.
Yeah, just a little warning for Cole there at the beginning of the round. Stay switched on, the fight's not over until the last bell. But Froch now demonstrating those boxing skills again. Good right hand to the body, left hook over the top. And dominating again here, going into the last minute of the final round.
He's really come back well if he was shaken up. And Arthur Abraham looks completely dispirited. He seems to know that there's a good left-right get-through from Froch. Tried the speculative right uppercut. But perhaps that strong start to the 12th and final round was his last roll of the dice. It hadn't paid off. Froch remained on his feet and remained in control of this contest.
Yeah, real spring in the step, isn't there, of Carl Froch? He knows he's there. Abraham's now desperation. Last 20 seconds and now complaining about a hit on the back of the head.
Referee having none of it, though. So into the final 10 seconds we go. Carl Froch on the verge of regaining his WBC. Oh my goodness, but he's caught by a right hand. He caught him to hold on, but surely he can see out the storm. Indeed he can. He raises his hands instantly. Takes the acclaim of the crowd. Acclaim from his girlfriend, Rachel Cordingley, because surely they know, and the entire Hartwell Arena know here in Finland, that Carl Froch has regained his WBC super middleweight title with a veritable punch-perfect performance against King Arthur Abraham.
Yeah, you said it, Ron. That was a punch-perfect performance from round one. Him and his trainer, Robert McCracken, done a great job. They stuck to the game plan. Robert obviously had a game plan for him. Cole stuck to the game plan, worked well behind the jab, kept everything at long range, which we didn't expect him to do. We thought he would eventually get drawn into a fight, but made that fight so easy. And I had him dominating there, 120-108, winning every round, and a clear victory there from Carl Froch.
Not just us who questioned whether he could resist the urge to get into a fight. He said himself, what would happen if he does get tagged? They would see Kalle Sauerland. No celebration this time from the Sauerland camp. They insisted that the contest be on neutral territory. It has been on neutral territory. And Carl Froch appears to have prevailed with a dominant display. Congratulatory hug from his girlfriend Rachel Cordingley. And look at the contrasting emotions.
Well, there was just no sense of urgency from Arthur Abraham through the whole 12 rounds, Ron. He knew he was falling behind round after round. Froch was putting the rounds in the bag. But Abraham never gave any real sense of urgency, did he?
Indeed he didn't, but we have to credit Carl Froch for that. He implemented that game plan and strategy so well that Abraham was just unable to adapt. And to be fair, Carl Froch said you can't teach an old dog new tricks.
Well, he certainly got that right, didn't he? But Froch showed and demonstrated the boxing skills that took him to a silver medal in the World Championships as an amateur.
Abraham looking despondent. Jubilation. There we see the strong start to the round from him. That right hand landed somewhere around the back of the head. We see Carl Froch returning the compliment. Abraham complained about it, but the American referee said boxed on.
Well, to be fair,
just waiting for the official verdict.
Yeah, to be fair, I think Abraham was just looking for something to complain about. I mean, you didn't see Froch complaining when the elbows were going in. But here, I think we're going to get the verdict.
So, a sporting touch of blood between the two fighters. Abraham appears to know that he's a beaten man tonight. Carl Froch.
Ladies and gentlemen, 12 rounds of action. We have a unanimous decision. Here are the score totals. Judge at ringside, Bert Clement, scores the bout 119 to 109. Judges Max DeLuca and Oren Schellenberger both score the bout 120 to 108. All three in favor of the winner. And having regained his title, he is now the two-time WBC super middleweight champion of the world, Carl the Cobra Froch.
So Carl the Cobra Froch is announced the winner. And once again, the WBC super middleweight champion of the world, the first British fighter to regain this title, which has played such a big part in British boxing history. The scorecard just reflected what we were saying throughout the contest, a dominant display, a shutout display, and Carl Froch will once again proudly wear that green strap of the WBC super middleweight champion of the world. It's around his waist, and he's jubilant.
Yeah, he deserves it, doesn't he? I mean, a masterclass of boxing there from Carl Froch, demonstrating tremendous skills, excellent variety, punched perfect this evening, really pleased. He's gone out there, got that belt back.
So Carl Froch finishes this stage of the Super 6 World Boxing Classic on a total of 4 points, his two victories coming by way of points. And guess what that means, Spencer? The semi-final is going to be a rematch of the contest that we've just had. He'll face Arthur Abraham, and we hope, from Carl Froch's point of view, that it's a repeat of the performance, because he was superb tonight.
Yeah, he certainly was, wasn't he? And I mean, Abraham's got a lot of homework to do if he's going to try and turn that around, because that, for me, was completely dominant. Now we're going to go through, have a look at the contest. Well, this is right from the opening bell, Carl Froch dominating.
And we can just take, if we can just get a snippet of action which shows Carl Froch boxing at range and Arthur Abraham falling short with his shots, then that will be all you need to know about this contest, because it was the same from the opening bell to the final bell, bar one brief aberration at the start of round 12 for Carl Froch.
Yeah, it certainly was, when it was almost punch perfect. Froch stuck to the game plan. That was the key. Everything behind the left jab. He knew Abraham didn't move his head. Abraham started to get disheartened from the midway point and then looked broken by about round 10. And this is why Froch throwing clusters of punches. That lovely jab through the middle that was so effective, that really took everything out of Arthur Abraham, and a tremendous punch-perfect performance. There we see a brief time that Froch actually did get caught. Apart from that, completely dominant, and rightly so, victorious at the end of it.
Jubilation at the final bell. Carl Froch is once again the WBC super middleweight champion of the world.